of your screen, Jupiter King at the bottom. And to continue that same thought, Anaban's a player who is not a one-trick, and instead he's mechanically really, really good at with every single card. It makes him very versatile. And so part of that with how good Chivas is at analysis is you can really give him anything to play and he can play it well. It gives their analysis team a lot of flexibility. And those two things combined are part of why Anaban was so successful in No Tilt.
And it makes it so incredibly difficult for your opponent to game or strategize against someone like that when they are as versatile as they are and when they can really lean into favorable matchups. So Jupiter King here at the bottom of your screen, Anaban at the top, two people that really, really had their coming out party with No Tilt and the things that Koji and Manu are doing over there. And I'm very, very excited to see what both of them can do here in CRL. You've heard their names for years and years, especially Anaban when it comes to ladder. This is a big time 1v1 matchup.
Yeah, I mean, both these rookies, but it's funny to say rookie with the experience level between the two of them overall. Jupiter King crush it at No Tilt, Anaban crush it at No Tilt, and of course Anaban known as the King Sniper on ladder, but
yeah.
He's certainly adding more to that reputation now with the way he's performing in the professional leagues. We'll see if he does more here, and it's looking like
wow.
Anaban is just going straight Anaban here. Very, very interested.
And I really like the Lumberjack up front to Rage Up the P.E.K.K.A. Protect it from that Inferno Dragon. He gets the reset. Baby Dragon now distracting the Inferno, and then Raged Up Baby Dragon getting a couple belches in. Yes, Jupiter King ended up getting the best that he could out of that situation, but Anaban did a great job of taking his Elixir advantage and turning up the heat.
So a pretty quick cycle graveyard deck for Jupiter King. Dark Prince and Inferno Dragon. You understand why the Inferno Dragon's in here up against Anaban. Anaban known very much for P.E.K.K.A. Loon, and you see the P.E.K.K.A. here, so we'll see what the rest of this looks like, but definitely happy to have that Inferno Dragon is Jupiter King as we go into the final minute of regulation play. Double Elixir time kicking off, and a second graveyard just put a little pressure there on the back end.
Yeah, and I'm really curious to see what other spells Anaban has here. There's the balloon coming out behind the P.E.K.K.A. I think we all were expecting it, but now it's going to be about getting that
balloon
in the tower.
There's
the freeze. But now finally turns around, Jupiter King is like, look, man, we all know you very, very well. He saves and holds the Goblin Cage, and that was some really, really nice defense from the tribe representative.
So fans of Anaban have to be going nuts right now. P.E.K.K.A. Loon freeze in his very first game of CRL. Very interesting. Although with Snowball, the Cage to pull things around, and the Inferno Dragon, we'll see if Jupiter King can hold off against that combination. Puts down another graveyard in the back, keeping pressure on the opposite side. Poison for the Ice Whiz and a little bit on the tower as well. So right now it's Jupiter King with the lead as we go into sudden death overtime. 1175 right-hand side for the Chiefs representative and 1906 on that right-hand side, and a solid kite getting that rage up Lumberjack away from the action, but it comes back due to the Dark Prince. Freeze up high right now. Anaban trying to get that P.E.K.K.A. to go on tower. Might a balloon come around the back end once that Inferno Dragon goes down?
There's the balloon coming out. Archer's coming down to defend. Jupiter King really, really hanging on here still. I mean, this is the thing, is he's got such a great quick cycle and he's all the answers that he pressure on the tower with the graveyard and then poison out using units to defend.
Ice Golem kiting away on the P.E.K.K.A. This time Jupiter King not going to make that same mistake. A tornado pulls it all together with the freeze. Baby Dragon trying to get some splash damage on tower. Doesn't do it. Behind by a couple hundred HP is Anaban. Jupiter King putting pressure on the opposite side. There is a half health P.E.K.K.A. going on the left hand side, but this graveyard all over the tower on the right. 48 seconds left.
And he can just kite that P.E.K.K.A. around all day long. No problem. You get the tank coming down from the archers with the Ice Golem that is kiting the P.E.K.K.A. Freeze comes in again for Anaban, but he's already back around. He being Jupiter King to any tank that he needs. Archer's still alive in the back, and then an easy poison graveyard on top of that Princess Tower on the top right. And Anaban is now feeling the pressure, knowing that there's no way for him to stop these pushes. Jupiter King, maybe.